Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is a zero-day local privilege elevation vulnerability in the latest version of Windows. Today's story is kind of surprising since it's not every day that a researcher randomly drops a significant zero-day vulnerability affecting Microsoft Windows. But that's just what happened as a Twitter user named Sandbox Escaper kind of released a weird tweet that talked about how they weren't really happy about their life, and they dropped something called a local privilege elevation flaw. Now, I won't go into a ton of technical detail about the flaw, but there is a GitHub post that contains the detail and also has a proof of concept, but essentially the flaw has to do with Windows's advanced local procedure call mechanism. And basically the attacker can leverage this flaw to make any unprivileged user gain system access or full access to a Windows operating system, including the latest 64-bit version of Windows 10. Now there are some caveats. The researcher says there's some Windows processes that have a protection and can't leverage this. For instance, you can't apparently leverage it against calculator, but you can against notepad. But really, it's a pretty serious flaw. The only thing that would make this worse is it being remote. This is not remote. Someone actually needs to have an account on your Windows computer, but it could allow even a guest user to actually gain full system privileges. So it is a big deal as far as a local vulnerability. The systems I'd be most worried about this for is any shared system that has any sort of guest access for it. Now, I will say the Twitter post for this is kind of unusual in that the researcher doesn't seem to really care about their life. They seem to be pretty negative in general as they drop this zero day. And I even went to the researcher's blog and they don't seem to be currently a very happy person. That said, I tend to not like it when researchers release zero day without following some sort of responsible disclosure policy. Regardless of what's happening in this researcher's life, I think it really is better for the whole world, especially customers, to actually tell vendors about these flaws before making them public in this way. So I personally don't like this irresponsible disclosure, even if I can feel some empathy for a researcher feeling bad. In any case, that aside, it is a flaw that has been validated, even validated by members of CERT, so it is a big deal. The crappy thing about this story is it is truly a zero-day flaw. There really is no mitigation I can offer you until Microsoft patches. If someone can log into your Windows instance, even with a guest account, they can leverage this flaw. So I guess the main practical tips is to try to limit physical access to your Windows machines, don't expose remote services that have guest accounts, and realize that any unprivileged user can become system on a Windows system until this gets fixed. And of course, as soon as Microsoft releases a patch, we will let you know. That's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.